Okay.
What can I tell you about slap? I think the big deal with slap is it's all about rhythm. The actual note content isn't hugely important. So you need to work out some rhythmic stuff that feels good, so you can do it with authority and conviction. And that's the first thing you need to know about, I guess, the idea that you can slap with both hands. You can wallop the low E string with your thumb and then wallop it again, maybe with a couple of fingers on this hand. I quite like to break it up sometimes so that there's more than one slapping agent on this hand here. So I could have a triplet like that, or four notes. And then you kind of punctuate that with some pulled notes. It's almost one of those things where you can get better at it just by drumming on your leg while you're waiting for the bus. It's all about just being aware of something resembling snare drum rudiments. And the important thing is that you stay in time. It's got to feel good. So if you try and be extra aware of certain important notes in rhythmically important parts of the bar. So you can try and get lost slightly or confuse the rhythmic vibe, but never lose track of where one is. It's good maybe to tap your foot or bang your head subtly while you're doing it, so that there's some kind of biological pulse going on and you never feel like you're just drifting. Whether you're just outlining the beat in a very obvious way or abandoning it so that you can come back and meet it on beat one of the next bar. Never lose where the beat is, and then this stuff should sound good. Also, it sounds infinitely more cool if you envelope filters. Is there anything they can't do? If you whack one of those on, suddenly it doesn't bother you so much that 80% of the lick isn't actual notes. It's all just percussive stuff. Happy slapping.